Hi folks, Christy from Shark Pixel here. I am thrilled to be with you today. We are going to be talking about how to easily and effortlessly remove wrinkles from clothing in a fraction of the time that you might be used to. So let me show you the image that we're going to be doing. So you can see here that we were able to remove those wrinkles in the shirt, even in a shirt that has significant texture to it. We were able to remove those wrinkles very fast and very easily using frequency separation as our method. But before I pop into showing you how easy it is to use frequency separation to remove wrinkles, I did want to just mention, please go ahead and subscribe here. I know you're going to learn something in this video. Make sure that you do tick this bell so that we are alerted when I come out with a new video like I just did 9 minutes ago, and this one allows you to actually download a free custom beauty brush for skin retouching. But I want you guys to know when these videos come out because they're always going to be beneficial for you and you are going to learn something. So go ahead and just subscribe if you choose to. And if not, you can test this method out. And if you find that you've learned something, then that's great. Okay, so what we're gonna do is use frequency separation to remove wrinkles from clothing. So I have actually gone ahead and run my frequency separation action, which I am going to be giving you guys to download. I'm going to give you the 8-bit file frequency separation layer setup, and I am going to be giving you the 16-bit file frequency separation actions that you can install. And so what I've done is I've run these actions on two different images. We have our crackled paint, and then we also have our wrinkled paper. I have divided this image into two sections, okay? One is going to be the low tone, the color and the tone data. The other is going to be the texture data. So this is your high frequency data, your texture, and your low frequency data is your color and tone. So frequency separation is basically just dividing your image into two sections. One section is going to include the texture, and the other section is going to include the color. And that's why you're dividing your image, and that's kind of what frequency separation is all about. So I've got my high texture layer here, and I want you guys to see what's actually on this layer. I'm gonna go ahead and change the blend mode of this layer to normal. And you can see that this is all the texture layer has on it. It starts with medium gray, it starts with 50% gray, and then there are tiny little highlights and tiny little shadows that are applied to the texture. But once we take this texture layer and we set it to a blend mode of linear light, you can see that if I turn the visibility of my frequency separation folder on and off, you don't see any difference. This is one of the big problems and frustrations that beginner users have when it comes to frequency separation, is they do all these steps and they look at their image and they turn the visibility of their folder on and off and nothing happens. So that is one of the most frustrating things about learning frequency separation. Again, I have done the exact same thing on this image, where I've taken the crackled paint and I've taken the crackledness texture, and I have divided the crackledness texture, which we see on these layers here, from the color data in the image, which is on low tone, right? So if I take, again, my high texture layer and I change the blend mode from linear light back to normal, you can see what's on this specific texture layer. So this is looking a little bit different than the texture layer on my other image, right? But as soon as we go back to linear light, you can see no difference as I turn this on and off. And again, that is why it's so frustrating. So what happens if I take this high texture layer from this image and I click and I drag it and I drop it onto this image here? For the moment, what I'm going to do is turn off the native texture layers from my crackled paper so that I'm just dealing with the texture layer from my other file, which was the paint. So if I take this layer and I change the blend mode from normal to linear light, and let's hit Command or Control T to transform this and make it a little bit bigger, just for explanation's sake. You can see that we have the texture from the white, creamy, crackled paint image, but it's laying on top of the color and the tone data from our crackled paper. So this is what I mean when I'm talking about dividing your image into two sections, your texture and your color. So how does this apply when we are talking about removing wrinkles from clothing? So when you do that, okay, let's start here. The most important thing to think about when you're thinking about frequency separation is what is the proper radius for what I am trying to do. And when you think about it in that way, it opens up the ability to use frequency separation in ways you never would have thought of before. So, yes, I am going to give you the actions, but I do also want you to watch me manually build the different layers within frequency separation. So what we're going to do is we're going to select our background layer. We're going to hit Command or Control J twice. Command or Control J. We're going to turn the visibility of our top layer off, and we're going to rename these layers. So here is our color and tone. And this layer is going to be called texture and detail. Now you could say, you know, that this is low frequency and this is high frequency, but in my opinion, those terms don't really lend you anything good when you're working, right? Because we want everything to be descriptive. So we've got our image here, color and tone. At this point, we're going to choose filter, noise, and we're going to choose median. What I need to do is start at a very, very small radius. Okay, so we're starting at a radius of 1 pixels. I am looking for the radius that is going to properly divide my image. And if I'm going to do that, I need to find a radius where the print or the texture of my shirt is not visible anymore. This is the same way you approach setting up your layers for frequency separation when you are doing skin retouching. But today we're applying it in a different way. So I'm going to go ahead and increase my radius until those white polka dots disappear from the shirt. Because I know that I want those white polka dots to be on the texture or the high frequency layer and not necessarily on the low frequency layer, because I'm going to try and blur out these wrinkles. So I think a radius of 9 is good. We're going to go ahead and press OK. Then we're going to select our texture and detail layer. We'll turn it on. There's all of our polka dots, remember? And we're going to go to image. We're going to go to apply image. We're going to make sure that our layer is our color and tone. And we're going to subtract the data that is missing from our color and tone layer. And we're going to put everything that's left onto our new texture and detail layer. You do want to make sure that your scale is set to 2 and that your offset is set to 128. We can go ahead and press OK. Our last step is going to be to change the blend mode of our texture and detail layer to linear light. And at this point, if I turn these layers on and off, you see no difference. So that is definitely one of the most frustrating things about frequency separation when you're first starting off. What I want to do now is I'd like to blur some of these wrinkles away. So to do that, I can go ahead and take my color and tone layer, and I can duplicate this by hitting Command or Control J. Now we'll go to our filter menu. We'll choose blur, and we're going to choose surface blur. Now, remember when I said that your radius and your threshold are going to be unique per your image? What I have done is I have put together these images, which you will be able to download and follow along with this so that you can use these specific integers while you're working on this. But you've got to remember that this technique is going to have unique radiuses and unique thresholds depending on the image that you're working on, right? So not every single image is going to have a radius of 5 and a threshold of 15. And there are lots of aspects that affect, you know, what you are going to be doing. So I'm just going to go ahead and increase this radius until I start to see those wrinkles disappear. And then I'd like to increase my threshold too. So you may be asking yourself, what exactly is the difference between radius and threshold when it comes to blurring things? So your radius, for example, is going to be, if you're trying to blur a pixel in Photoshop, it's going to need to know how, which colors to blur it to, right? Because you can't just blur one pixel by itself because there's just one color within that pixel. So how far away from that pixel that you're trying to blur do you want to incorporate the colors into so that it blurs well? So radius is basically the strength of the blur, if you will. Threshold is going to be if you run into a situation where there's a highly contrasted area, do you want to blur that or not? So threshold is kind of like, you know, your high contrast areas, where do you want this to cut off? Where do you want this not to happen on? And that's what your threshold level is. So we'll go ahead and press OK. And at this point, I'd like to put a black mask over my color and tone copy layer. So we'll hold down Option or Alt, and we're going to click on the black mask button. Now you can see how much that shirt actually blurred. And we'll turn the visibility of our texture and detail layer back on. Then we're going to select the mask, the black mask of our blur layer. Let's go ahead and color and tone. Let's call this blur. So let's select the mask. We're going to choose the brush tool. We'll make sure that we are painting with white. And I'm going to come on in here and I'm just going to paint away those wrinkles in the shirt. Okay. That is going to be one of the easiest methods for removing wrinkles in clothing. So here's the one thing that I want you guys to keep in mind when you're doing this kind of thing. This would not necessarily be the way that I would use frequency separation on skin, but if we go on and off, you can see how easy it was for us to actually remove all of those wrinkles extremely fast, okay? Now, if I was working on skin, which I do have an entire 2-hour course on using frequency separation for skin and for hair and for all sorts of different things, but for this specifically, when it comes to clothing, you can get away with using a heavier-handed method like the surface blur that we used, okay? So again, I'm going to run this again on this image. Now you can see what's the difference between this sweater and the shirt that we just ran the frequency separation action on and cleaned up the shirt that we just, where is that one? This one, the shirt that we just cleaned up. What's the difference? Well, this one has a very distinct, very visible print. And this image, which we're going to be working on now, has a much tinier print, right? There's almost no print at all, to be honest, but there is some texture on this sweater. So that means we're gonna have to rethink what exactly our proper radius is going to be when we run this action. So I did show you manually how to set up your layers. I'm gonna run the action this time for us to save time. So here's one of my notes. from our frequency separation action, and then our median blur comes up. I will start at one again, and now I'm looking for a radius that's going to remove the texture of the sweater, like the fuzz or the texture of the sweater, without affecting the wrinkles, okay? And so remember, when we did it previously, our radius was, I think, at 8 or 9, but now we've got a radius of, let's do a radius of 5. Okay, so we'll go ahead and press okay on that. And our action has finished. And so I'm gonna teach you a different method at this point. I'm going to turn my high texture layers off. I'm gonna turn the visibility of them off. I'm gonna choose my retouch layer, which is automatically created for you in the action. And then I'm gonna use the mixer brush for this. Now this is a different method. This is a method that's much more detail oriented. This is the method that I use whenever I'm using frequency separation on skin specifically. And what I'm doing here is I'm just gonna click and smush like colors together. And that's going to allow me to remove these wrinkles while still keeping the unique shape of the sweater underneath it. So I'm not trying to remove, you know, too much about how the sweater's fitting on her. Instead, what I want to just do is I want to just get rid of those wrinkles that I see there and then keep the unique shape. So I'm just using my mixer brush and I'm smushing and blending like colors together in a very light-handed kind of way. So I'm not going overboard here, and that's what I want to show, and that's what I want you guys to learn, is that there are multiple methods of using frequency separation and of blurring within the frequency separation action. So there's multiple methods on how to do it. So there's not necessarily a specific right way or a specific wrong way to use frequency separation. So keep that in mind. Like if people are just judging you and being super judgy and saying, no, you're doing it wrong, you're not supposed to do it that way, just don't listen to them. You know, like there's like 1,000 ways to do everything in Photoshop. So don't let anyone tell you that that's the wrong way to do it. There may be a faster way, but you're still getting the good, you know, you're still getting good results. So now that we have done our blending, if we turn our texture layers back on, you can see that we were able to easily remove wrinkles again using that action, using the exact same technique, but instead of blending using our surface blur method, I blended using the mixer brush. Now, I do want to just point out that if you run the mixer brush on your retouch layer, if you use the mixer brush on your retouch layer because your retouch layer is actually empty, you do need to make sure that you have sample all layers checked within the mixer brush. And there's another tip that's very important. If you run and blend the colors together with the mixer brush while your texture layers are visible, let me show you what happens. Do you see that extra texture showing up? That's not what we want, right? We're trying to blend the color without affecting the texture whatsoever. So those really need to be off. The visibility of the texture layers needs to be off as you blend and as you use the mixer brush, and then you can turn it back on. And there's actually a benefit to using frequency separation in this way, especially when you're getting started with this technique. And that is, it really helps you as a beginner user see exactly what's on the color layer and exactly what's on the texture layer. So it does actually help you specifically with your learning curve when it comes to this. So I have put together this image for you. It's a free image that you can download. I've also put together the image of this, so this is in the download as well. And then I've also included in our download your two actions, your shark pixel 8-bit and your Shark Pixel 16-bit frequency separation actions, which are going to automate this all for you. Again, if you have learned something in this video, please go ahead and subscribe and make sure you tick that bell so that you are alerted every single time I come out with a new video. And hopefully you did learn something from this video. So if you did, please go ahead and like it and leave a comment. Hopefully I have saved you some time when it comes to your retouching moving further and your Photoshop journey. So if I have saved you some time, please go ahead and just say, thanks so much. Definitely going to use this in the future. Downloading your actions. That was awesome, or something like that. Okay, so that's it for this video. I hope you guys have enjoyed this, and I will see you guys on the next course.